Africa was colonized. All countries have been colonized, and the independence was around 60, except Egypt, around 20. So all these countries didn't know revolution, industrial revolution. When they begin in 60s independent, they have no faculty of science. Tunisia was 500 students, 3% female at the independence. 2 PhD over all the country at that moment. And population was 5 million at that moment, almost. We are today 10 million, and we have, you know, until now, little number of PhD in Tunisia for all students. You see the increase of students. The increase of students along the years. We begin less than 20, 2000, now we are 370,000 students. So it is exponential. They asked me to speak about my story success, but it could be easier to speak about unsuccess story, how to develop research. I get my bachelor in physics in Tunisia, fellowship to go to France. They speak about master. Nobody knows what is master. Nobody knows what is PhD, what is research. Our professor coming from France, were professor. Going to France is coming to go to be again teacher, no more. I did my PhD, and when we come back to Tunisia, we were some of us who decide to come back to Tunisia. Even we were offered places in France. We decide to develop research. At that moment, there were less than 10 PhD over the country. Beginning research, it was around 80. Research development. There is no development without research, of course. So actually, research is about experience, theory, and simulation. So I did experiment in France. Repeating experiment in Tunisia has no meaning. So I decided to make simulation. And I had the chance to study interaction between atoms and to detect the potential interaction experimentally. To validate this measurement, excuse me, to validate the measurement, I need simulation. So coming to Tunisia, I decided to begin with simulation. It took 10 years to get the first paper. And simulation technique is not only for it is for many disciplines in physics. So we can ask people to have this training in simulation and to develop research by simulation in Africa. The computers are cheaper and more powerful. And more than that, young people, more and more familiar with computer, enjoy using them as a tool. So they can be involved very soon with computer science. Simulation could be then to develop research and contribute to the development. I did development in atomic and molecular physics and in molecular dynamics with ab initio calculation, DFT, with some software, Molpro, Gaussian, and so on, with fit procedure. What kind of research? We study basic, fundamental research, application, and valorization, from simple to complex, from diatomic molecules to aggregates to biological molecules. Application to astrophysics, to agriculture, to biology, to environment, to pharmaceutical. All these possibilities are when we study simulation of atoms and molecules interaction. We begin with potential interaction. We study collision between atoms. We study solvation. We did this because we like it to have some connection with biologists, with agriculture people. Next step is development of experiment. Why? because we need some visibility. We need to interest national people, national, the ministry of and the environment, local environment. So the development should be for simple experiment.
Please, Professor, go to your conclusion, please.
Yes. So this simple experiment should give some information about local product as oxidation of oil. The strategy is to have good students, local and foreign students, and to make cooperation north-north and south-south. South-south cooperation, it has been done by ICTP. I was in ICTP, and thanks to ICTP for Office of External Activities, who helped us to develop this Net 45 project from two countries' interaction. We are now six African countries working in our lab for PhD, for master, and we develop now a new laboratory in atomic and molecular physics in Cameroon. These countries are Chad, Central Africa, Senegal, Tunisia.
I'm sorry, Professor Lakhdar.
Algeria, and so on. Yeah. Okay, thanks. Perspective, just to say what is my perspective, is to extend Net 45 to all countries and to become international one. To make master and computing in atomic and molecular physics in Tunisia, in Africa. We are actually a laboratoire international associé to CNRS in France, but we like to be pilot in computing in molecular physics and dynamic of molecules in Africa. Thank you very much.